This month on Main Sail, we're in Sydney, Australia, at one of the sport's most grueling of offshore challenges, the famous Rolex Sydney-Hobart race. It's a 630 nautical mile dash across some of the most challenging stretches of water in the Southern Hemisphere. Here in Australia, this event is by far the biggest in the sailing calendar. And the star attraction is the 8 times winner and the current record holder, Wild Oats 11. In the 2012 edition, Wild Oats beat our existing record to set a new time of just 1 day, 18 hours and 23 minutes. A phenomenal achievement, but no real surprise, because this boat has also been first across the line in Hobart a remarkable 8 times.
Wild Oats 11 is the essential fabric, I think, of the Rolex Sydney-Hobart since the turn of the century. To win this race across the line 8 times, the toughest ocean race in the world, is just amazing. So to see that boat leading the others out of Sydney Harbour in that race to Hobart on Boxing Day is just amazing. It does almost stop the nation.
Although Wild Oats won last year, the 2014 edition saw a brave new challenger take on the race for the first time. Last year's Sydney Hobart was the first outing for Super Maxi Comanche. With a year of successful racing now under her belt, she's back.
In fact, Comanche poses such a threat this year that the Wild Oats of 2015 has a very different look about her. She spent much of this year going under the knife.
We had a great race last year. Obviously Comanche came out and showed a lot of new tricks that were available in today's world, I guess. To stay in touch with these guys, we had to do something. Building a new boat was just out of the question. It's just way too expensive in today's world. So the idea of, you know, chopping 7 feet off the back and 30 off the front and putting a new 37-foot bow section on, that's what happened. Here she is today in her new form, and I've got to say we're very excited about the way she's performing, and I think she's going to be, certainly brought her back up to the current level she needed to be.
Talk to the local sailing press here in Sydney and they'll tell you Wild Oats is still the firm favourite. But our biggest rival, Comanche, is built with one thing in mind. She's wider. She's a more recent build with a big budget. She runs a who's who crew list. The 100-foot Super Maxi Comanche has had quite the year. Since crossing the line second to Wild Oats 11 last year, she set a new 24-hour monohull sailing record and was the first monohull to finish the prestigious Rolex Fastnet race. And all the talk here in Sydney is of the showdown between these two sailing monsters.
Wild Oats is the big dog here. All the accolades is very deserving. They've done an incredible job with that boat, with that program over the years. They have nothing to prove. We have something to prove. So I guess really the pressure's on us. We gotta step it up.
And in their bid to win, the team at Comanche are pulling no punches. 2 times America's Cup winner, current America's Cup holder, and Oracle Team USA skipper Jimmy Spittle has joined the afterguard. Comanche's 20-strong crew list for the 2015 Sydney Hobart has racked up over 1 million offshore miles between them. But there's one name in reserve that's desperate to get the call. Australian Christy Hines-Clark is co-owner of the boat with her husband, Netscape billionaire Jim Clark. And if the weather allows, she could be one of the crew.
I've never actually done it aboard before, so I imagine it's pretty exciting. I even grew up watching Wild Oats and barracking for it, so it's a pretty big thing to take it on. But, you know, I think it's also good for the race that they've got competition now. There is one objective, and you know, hopefully we'll get, you know, the weather to be able to do it this year. We didn't come down here to come second again.
While the big battle is expected to be between the two Super Maxis, there's 108 boats taking on this year's Sydney Hobart. And although there's a host of entries from abroad hoping to attempt an upset, my outside favourite would be with another local sailing icon. There's one man in this fleet of accomplished sailing royalty that can claim above all to be the authority on the Sydney Hobart race, Australian Sid Fisher. Incredibly, this is his 47th race. Twice he has crossed the line in first place, and at 88, he'll be taking on the fleet in his Super Maxi Ragamuffin.
I think you just do your best and hope the gods give you a break. I think some of my family are very, very keen, and the others just think I'm a nutcase. I'll stop when I can't do it.
Sid's a very colourful bloke, and I think, to use a cliche, he's as hard as nails. He's an icon on the sport. Especially in this country, I don't think you could have a Hobart race without Sid Fisher.
What does it take to win this?
If I knew that, I've been trying for 22 years. I don't know the answer to that.
This year's Rolex Sydney to Hobart race is shaping up to be the closest fought ever. We'll be back in part three with the whole race story. But before then, we're going to take a quick look at what else has been going on in the world of sailing this month.
Last month's mainsail took an in-depth look at the Jules Verne Trophy. And in November, Edex Sport and Spindrift began their attempt on the fastest lap of the planet. The challenge started well, and for over a month, the 45-day record appeared within their grasp. But in the final stages, their luck with the weather ran out, and Banque Populaire's 2010 record remains unchallenged, for now. The America's Cup World Series goes from strength to strength, and three brand new venues have been added to the lineup for 2016. With the opener in Oman in February, the series then moves to a much-anticipated event in Manhattan in New York. Toulon in southern France is the third new venue. Mainsail will be following all the action in the build-up to the America's Cup in Bermuda in 2017.